I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
At this moment, we would like to now introduce the gentleman.
Great, I'm going. It's going to be my first fight ever. I think he had a British accent, but Steve, you were talking about some European fans that were been in Los Angeles, and now they're here in Vegas.
Like I call it, Boxing Palooza 2017. I think boxing fans have certainly had this date circled on their calendar. And speaking of dates on the calendar, two come to mind. April 15th, 1985, a fight that man in the middle, Oscar De La Hoya, has referenced. That was Marvin Hagler and Tommy Hearns. And for the record, me and Doug were not ringside for that. We're not that old. But the one we were at, Madison Square Garden, in the aftermath of 9/11, September 29, 2001, there is a lot of similarities. Longtime middleweight champion, looking for respect, looking to transcend, who needed a bigger name star moving up in weight. This fight has a lot of similarities to that one.
Gennady Golovkin, Kazakhstan, undefeated. Canelo Alvarez only has one loss. That was to Floyd Mayweather, where some people said he was green for that one. Here they are, getting ready for Saturday night. Make sure you buy the fight on ringtv.com. The online pay-per-view will be available for you. Myself and Doug Fisher will be on the mic for that one. And remember, an earlier start time, so if you're on the East Coast or wherever you are around the world, it'll start off at 5 p.m. Pacific time with the main event around 8 o'clock. And there you see him, Canelo Alvarez, Jessica Rosales, fourth member of our crew, rocking the Under Armour, looking like she's ready to go do some Pilates or go do some Under Armour workouts, whatever she's going to do. He will be talking with Canelo in a few moments. And one thing that we've also noticed is reading about this, or Doug, you've been in camp, Steve, you all have been there with them. They've closed their camps. It's very tight, the circle.
Also, it is my pleasure to introduce the manager of Canelo Alvarez, who's been with him, all his career, and who has done a phenomenal job. That is Jose Chepo Reynoso. Jose.
Buenas tardes a todos ustedes.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Primero que nada, agradecerles toda la cobertura a todos los medios de lo que han hecho con esta pelea. De veras, muchas gracias.
I really want to thank you all the media, for all the coverage you've given this fight. Thank you so much.
Y decirles que, bueno, terminan 10 semanas de un trabajo intenso.
And to tell you that it's the end of 10 hard weeks of training.
Un trabajo con mucha disciplina, con mucha responsabilidad.
Work that was done with a lot of discipline and a lot of responsibility.
Y en el campamento de Canelo, nos declaramos listos.
And in Canelo's camp, we declare ourselves ready.
Y confiados.
Confident.
Que el sábado próximo vamos a ganar.
That come Saturday night, we
Saúl
are going to win.
Va a salir con la mano en alto.
And Canelo's going to come out with his hand raised.
Y quiero rematar con algo dedicado a mi amigo Abel.
And I want to close with a dedication to my friend Abel.
Dice Abel que Triple G.
Abel says that Triple
Mexicano.
G has a Mexican style.
Y yo, Chepo Reynoso.
And I, Chepo Reynoso.
Le digo a Abel.
Tell Abel.
Que el Canelo.
That Canelo.
Tiene estilo.
Has a style.
Corazón.
Heart.
Y es mexicano, gracias.
And he's Mexican. Thank you.
Muchas gracias a todos por estar aquí. Gracias por todo su apoyo que siempre me brindan.
Thank you to everyone for being here and thank you so much for all the support that you always give me.
Tampoco me gusta hablar mucho, simplemente decirles que estoy listo, estoy preparado para esto. Sé que va a ser una pelea muy dura.
And you know me, I don't like to talk a lot. I just want to say that I'm prepared. I know what it's going to be. It's going to be a tough fight. I know that.
Pero estoy listo para esto, una pelea que ustedes querían ver, aquí está. Disfrútenla como yo la voy a disfrutar. Nos vemos el 16 de septiembre.
And that's what I'm ready for. I just want you to all enjoy it like I'm going to enjoy it. I'll see you all on Saturday night.
Wonderful. Thank you very much to everyone who was watching on who is watching on ringtv.com. We will pose the fighters for pictures now and thank you very much and see you on Saturday night. Thanks.
All right, thank you guys. Now, Canelo, this is going to be the last time that you see Gennady until the weigh-in. What was it like right now with that face-off standing next to him? How did it feel?
No, muchas ganas de pelear. Emocionado por querer pelear. Eso es lo único que deseo, pelear y para lo que estoy listo.
I'm really, really excited. Really excited just to get in and fight, you know? The excitement's there. The adrenaline's there.
And we've got Roberto Diaz that's helping us to translate here, of course. And you said that you're not one to really talk a lot, but during this fight, as we've been kind of promoting it, there has been a lot of talk going back and forth between you and Gennady. What would you like to say to him? What would be the last thing that you want to say to him before the fight?
Nada, no tengo nada que decirle. No, yo creo que ellos saben el peleador que soy. Me gusta prepararme al 100%. Vengo listo para lo que sea arriba del cuadrilátero. Y simplemente que dé lo mejor de él para que sea una gran pelea.
I have nothing to say to him. They know what kind of fighter I am. I'm prepared. I'm ready. And all I want to tell them is, look, let's give the fans a great fight.
Absolutely. And speaking of the fans, they've been waiting for this fight, and they're getting just as excited as we are as Saturday comes closer. But what have you been hearing from the fans? I'm sure that they've been reaching out to you, social media, telling you how excited they are. How have the fans been reacting as the fight gets closer?
No, obviamente están emocionados igual que yo, no, igual que nosotros, están emocionados. Es una pelea que ellos querían ver y aquí está y creo que están igual de emocionados que nosotros por verla.
I think they're just equally emotional or excited as we are. It's a fight that they've been wanting to see, it's a fight that they've been asking for and we're just a few days away, so they're excited just like we are.
Thank you so much. Suerte este sábado. Roberto Diaz, Canelo helping us translate here. We're going to be getting Triple G in just a little bit, guys.
Well, this is the moment everyone's been waiting for. As I mentioned before, both sides have a lot of people associated with the promotion, both fighters, a lot of people associated personally with them. I have to say Abel knows Gennady just from spending so much time in his Big Bear training camp, the Summit Gym up in Big Bear, where he whips up his magic formula of knockouts up there and creates what everyone sees on fight night as Triple G. So Abel knows him intimately. I'd like to acknowledge his manager, Oleg Herman, who I met with Oleg about 6 years ago when he flew to Los Angeles looking for a new promoter. And ever since then, our philosophies have been the same. And it's been, for a team to work cohesively together, that's the result that you see when you have a very successful fighter. Like the great Bernard Hopkins alluded to on the stage, he had so many title defenses. When you have Gennady, this will be going on his 19th title defense if he's successful on Saturday night. So when you have someone of that stature, especially in the middleweight division, the glamour division of boxing, it takes a very strong team behind him. So with that, I'd like to bring up the IBO, the IBF, WBA, and WBC undefeated middleweight champion of the world, Gennady Triple G Golovkin. Yep, the vice president of programming at HBO Pay-Per-View, Tony Walker.
Thanks, Tom. Hello, everybody, and thank you all for coming out and supporting what's going to be a fantastic show on Saturday night. Congratulations to Tom and Oscar for putting this together. It is truly will be a momentous night on Saturday, and really a big thank you goes out to both Canelo and to Gennady for really embracing the show and listening to the fans and really wanting this fight. And what we end up with is the best fight that can be made in boxing, and potentially and probably a fight that we all are going to think about in years to come. We Oscar mentioned the new start time, and we ask that you help us publicize that to the public. Old habits die hard, and we want really everyone to know that the first fight will be in the ring at 5 p.m. local time, 8 p.m. Eastern time, and the main event is scheduled to go off around 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern time. So that all we want fans to do is order the fight early, because we know they want to, we know they're going to see it, and to just sit back and start that party early also. Getting to know the fighters has always been a big part of what we do when we promote these pay-per-view shows. And I would invite you to check out on the HBO digital platforms our episodes of 24/7 and Under the Lights, and some other video we have that really tells the backstories of the fighters. Really interesting stuff. And you get a sense and an idea of what has driven these two great fighters to the place they are now. HBO.com all this week will have a comprehensive look at Fight Week with interviews and the stories in a podcast. So go to HBOinsideboxing.com to get all the Fight Week coverage. Lastly, I want to thank all our distributors. From the day this fight was announced, we have had great support from the people who actually bring the fight to the consumer. They recognize what we have here on Saturday night, and I want to thank them for all their efforts and the fact that they've just continued to promote boxing in general. The suggested retail price for the fight is $69.95. As always, we promise you some insightful commentary and a fun telecast. And I also want to thank Mr. Sturman and the MGM Grand and their team. They're great hosts, and we really appreciate being here. See everybody Saturday night in what should be a very electric T-Mobile Arena. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tony. Thank you very much. Thank you for the patience. We are finally here. The final press conference. I first of all want to thank all the sponsors. I know Eric had the opportunity, the president of Golden Boy Promotions, to thank all the sponsors, but I really want to send my appreciation for everyone who's part of this great event. This is for supremacy. This is to see who is the best middleweight in the division, but to see who the best pound-for-pound fighter on the planet is. So I really am grateful for everyone in the boxing world, in the fight world, just coming together and making this event as big as it can be. And this event needs no hype whatsoever. You have Canelo Alvarez, who you know what he can do. You know what he's all about. You know the hard work he puts into his every single fight. He has obviously devastating punching power, tremendous speed, great footwork. Then you have the champion here, Gennady Golovkin, who is undefeated, has amazing, amazing power. So this is a fight that's a can't miss. That's the bottom line. You know, people ask me every single day. I mean, what type of fight are we gonna see? I really don't know. Obviously, I don't have a crystal ball in front of me to give you the prediction. But what people do know is that it's going to be a great, great fight because of what's at stake. And what's at stake is pride. It's pride and fighting for your country and fighting for boxing fans all over the world. This is a fight for the sport of boxing, and it couldn't have come at a better time. The stakes couldn't be any higher. I strongly feel that when you take a look at a fight like this one, it's really hard to remember when we've witnessed this type of matchup. It's been years. The only fight I really can compare it to on paper, you have to go back. You have to go back to the marvelous Marvin Hagler days. You have to go back to Thomas Hearns, you know. And we're still talking about that fight. That's exactly what this event is all about. I want to talk about, I want my kids, your kids will talk about Canelo Alvarez and Gennady Golovkin 20 years from now. That's the type of fight we have in our hands. A special fight. And so, you know, we at Golden Boy Promotions and working with Canelo and Golovkin and Tom Loeffler, you know, we are very, very proud of putting this event together. We have to thank the fighters for agreeing, fighting at the peak of their careers, because obviously without the fighters, this is not possible. Saturday night at the T-Mobile Arena, it will be electrifying. It'll be a packed house. We are happy to announce that the fight sold out in less than 2 weeks for a reason. And obviously that reason is because the world knows what we have on our hands, what we're going to witness on Saturday night, September 16th. And to top it all off, the special weekend, celebrating Mexican Independence Weekend is a big deal, is a huge deal all over the world. So not only are we going to witness an amazing fight, but we will be able to join forces, to come together and celebrate a wonderful weekend with our Mexican neighbors and our families all over the country, all over the world. So that's the reason why this weekend is so very special. This event will take place live on HBO pay-per-view. And beginning for the first time, I think ever, we will be starting at 8 p.m. Eastern. And that's in consideration of our East Coast fans and our global fan base who will be tuning in. We didn't want this event to start so late. So you know, fans will be able to appreciate the fact that we're beginning at 8 p.m. Eastern and 5 p.m. Pacific time, which is the very first time in the history of this sport. You can also watch it on ringtv.com, which obviously now these days, people do not want to be told what to watch and where to watch and what to watch it on. So you can now watch it on ringtv.com on your phone, on your tablet, from wherever you're at. So we're happy to announce that you can watch the fight on ringtv.com. I want to thank the MGM. I want to thank everyone here in Las Vegas who opened their doors to make this event possible. The hospitality has been amazing. I mean, the MGM is by far, one of our best partners we have in boxing. They love the sport. They are invested in boxing, and you can tell. You can tell by the hospitality that they're giving us here all this week. So thank you very much to everyone who is involved with the MGM. So this next gentleman that I'm about to introduce is a living legend. He knows a thing or two about the middleweight division and what it's like to be a middleweight. The pressure you carry on your shoulders, on your back, in being a middleweight, in being a champion, your responsibilities, not only to boxing, but to all the fans all over the world. They expect you to be to shine inside that ring because you're a middleweight champion. And so this next gentleman, not only did he break records and defend his title 20 times, but he was always willing to fight the very best at the peak of his career. And so it is my pleasure to introduce to you my partner at Golden Boy Promotions, the living legend, Bernard Hopkins.
Thanks, Oscar, and everyone that played a role in getting this historic moment to where we at now. The middleweight division goes all the way back, as most people here know. I mean, I'm going back to Ray Robinson when he moved up from welterweight, and even coming all the way up to, as Oscar mentioned, to the great Marvin Hagler. But this fight here, and I love history, and I like to look at tapes every now and then, even to the day. And I thought about when I got here yesterday from Philadelphia, the fight that really stands out to me when it comes to Golovkin and Canelo. And I see the danger in the first couple of rounds of the way both of them fight and the way one is more aggressive. And the first thing I thought about, if you remember the Marvin Hagler and the John the Beast Mugambi. John the Beast Mugambi was a guy that was destroying everybody, even the middleweights from Philadelphia. And anyone up here know about boxing, know about that era. And my era was my era, but now we're in this era, and I'm glad to witness it from a historic point of view, and also from a promotional point of view. So I'm very blessed, not lucky. It was meant to be. And I'd like to thank everybody that played a role in making this happen, because, you know, if you look at the time between 2001 in Madison Square Garden with Felix Trinidad and myself to 2017, don't judge me from a year off. I think that's 16 years. It doesn't happen all the time, but when it do happen, embrace it, enjoy it, and understand that history don't always repeat itself. But one thing will repeat themselves is the pride of the vision that I felt as my career was made and built on as the foundation that got me all the way up to the end. And so Canelo and Triple G thanks for respecting the division that made me. So again, enjoy it, fans, reporters from all over, and understand that history is something that we should always remember. The definition of that doesn't happen all the time. And no matter who you choose, no matter where you go, there'll never be forgotten what happened come the 16th on HBO pay-per-view. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Bernard. Next, I'd like to invite Mr. Bob Bennett. He's with the Nevada State Athletic Commission, up to say a few words. Bob.
Thank you, Oscar, and good afternoon. On behalf of the Nevada State Athletic Commission, first of all, we would like to thank Golden Boys Promotions and Triple G Promotions for having this world-class fight in the fight capital of the world. As always, the Nevada State Athletic Commission is humbled, honored, and privileged to be able to regulate this fight, or I should say this sensational fight. With that being kept in mind, you should know that we take a great deal of time and effort in the selection of our officials for this fight, as we do for all fights. And in this particular fight, we've selected Kenny Bayless as the referee, who has reffed over 70 championship and elimination bouts. World-class judges such as Adelaide Bird, who's judged over 115 championship and elimination bouts. World-class judge Dave Moretti, 169 championship and elimination bouts. And last but not least, Don Trella, who has judged 60 world-class and elimination bouts. Between the four officials, that gives us about 120 years of experience officiating this fight. I'm very proud of the aforementioned officials, and I'm sure they're going to do a great job. There's no doubt that we are unequivocally prepared and ready to go to work. And lastly, and probably most importantly, I would like to thank the fighters, Triple G, or Granati, whatever you like, don't knock me out, and Canelo. So thank you very much, and God bless.
Thank you very much, Bob.
Andy Golovkin with Jordan Brand. Oh, Tom Loeffler, not in the Jordan Brand here. He actually brought a suit to Las Vegas. There you see him posing off. I mean, that right there, in the 160-pound division, you have Bernard Hopkins, a Hall of Famer at the end, Oscar in the middle, and then Canelo and Triple G. Doug, this is something that obviously the hardcore fight fan has been climbing for a while, but I'm just looking through my Twitter and the responses. People are excited that don't really know much about boxing also.
Well, I mean, if you don't know a whole lot about the current boxing scene, if you're not a Canelo Alvarez fan, if you've never heard of Gennady Golovkin, you've certainly heard of great fighters like Marvelous Marvin Hagler. You heard about the Four Kings, Hagler versus Duran, Hagler versus Hearns, Hagler versus Leonard. That made an entire generation of fight fans who were now in their, you know, late 30s throughout their 40s. So the lineage of the middleweight championship and that grand history is part of this fight. And that's what Oscar De La Hoya talked about. That's what Bernard Hopkins talked about. And the great thing is that those great fighters and fights that we talked about, those were all fights of the year. And that's what people are expecting. So even if you don't know about these two participants now, you understand that it's going to be great once they step into the ring.
Getting out the elevator, coming into the arena today, saw a man who saw my credentials. He said, "Wow, you're working the fight? Great. I'm going. It's going to be my first fight ever." I think he had a British accent. But, Steve, you talked about some European fans that were been in Los Angeles, and now they're here in Vegas.
Like I call it, Boxing Palooza 2017, I think.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak. Take a step back, cause it's Ellie Sekpak.